give a standing applause to Mr. Naveen Patnaik, who is just coming in into the walking the stage. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Chawla. With this, we acknowledge the presence of the Honorable Chief Guest for the closing ceremony. The Honorable Chief Minister, Odisha, Shri Naveen Patnaik ji is here. Shri Patnaik has lent invaluable support to this festival through his presence right from the first chapter. May I now request Editorial Director, New Indian Express, Mr. Prabhu Chawla, to kindly escort the Honorable Chief Minister to the stage and welcome him with a bouquet. It's a privilege to have the Honorable Chief Minister with us as the chief guest of the closing ceremony. The editorial director welcoming the Honorable Chief Minister with bouquet. And over to Mr. Chawla now for a small conversation.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome, Honorable Chief Minister Mr. Naveen Patnaik. We are really grateful to you for having given us this opportunity to welcome you again for the fifth time in a literary festival. Because there are many people who make many records, but I was doing some research that how many chief ministers have inaugurated literary festival. For five times in a row, I couldn't find anyone. So that reflects his commitment also, because politicians are not known for literary narrative. They are known for abusive narrative, dialogue, tutu, mamen, etc., whatnot. But Sir Naveen Patnaik, whenever I requested him, he had never even thought second time that I would not come. He is always, one letter goes and I get a prompt reply, yes, I would be coming here. And that is one of the reasons why we are hosting Odisha Literary Festival here, because the crowd is good, authors are good, and the patronage which we get from the Chief Minister, because he also wrote one book. When I first time invited him, I didn't know that he was an author also. So he has also real connection with the literary world. Mr. Naveen Patnaik is known for many, many better things. He came minister before even joining the political parties. And among the 30 chief ministers, and about, I counted the number of chief ministers the country had during the last 60 years, there have been about 290 chief ministers in various states. Around 290, 293, I was mixing the number of chief ministers with the number of individuals, because one individual becomes twice, thrice, then he becomes the number of times chief minister. That is how the Wikipedia and everybody shows. About 300 odd chief ministers. Naveen Patnaik is the only person who has completed more than 15 years after Jyoti Basu. He will complete 20 years because his mandate is till for 20 years. He's the only one, because I was trying to do study some speeches made by him. Because politicians have the habit of breaking records and speaking more and more what is not required even. I couldn't find in 16 years, I don't think he has spoken more than 16,000 words. 1,000 words a year, and that words, the words he speaks, they carry the mandate with them. So he's one of them, like our Modi says, minimum government, maximum governance. For him, I think his mantra seems to me, by studying his politics, studying his analysis, knowing him personally. He believes in, Modi sahab believes in minimum government, maximum governance. Naveen Patnaik believes in minimum words, maximum work, with a minimized and marginalized opposition. Because he doesn't believe in speaking, because he says work it, my words should speak about it. And whenever I speak, he gives some answer, which I hope he will give today also. And he's also broken many other records. When he took over as a journalist, we were known, Odisha was known for Kala Handi, hunger strike, natural calamities, whatnot. It happened during once his time also. But that is a thing of the past. Odisha is one of the agriculture surplus states now. I think wagons were coming, trains were coming in full of food about 20 years ago, and food was distributed here. Now, if you look at the parameters of agricultural production, I think Odisha is one of the best states after Punjab and Haryana. So that is one thing he must have done quietly, which was not known to anybody else. Odisha is still back and beyond. People is not recognizing Odisha at all. But Naveen Patnaik, like his father, may not have gone to the national stage. But everybody is trying to study this enigmatic personality, how this person who hardly communicates with people, but they have a full faith in him. They think that he is delivering, and he is delivering more than what he has been promising. So he has fulfilled one promise here of coming to us and deliver the lecture. I will not stand between him and you, and I will request him to give us some words of wisdom so that we can start the training. Thank you, Mr. Vinayan.
Shri Prabhu Chawla, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I take this opportunity to congratulate the organizers of the Odisha Literary Festival on the success of this exciting cultural event. I have no doubt that this annual event, held under the auspices of the New Indian Express, has met the highest standards of excellence the organizers have set themselves. Over the course of 2 days, novelists, poets, lyricists, and scholars engaged in a very lively exchange of ideas. This exchange illuminates aspects of our experience of a world in transition and helps us to see them from refreshingly new perspectives. The discussion expands and deepens our understanding of the very important role literature plays in the life of a community. Literature also makes human beings conscious of the need to assert their unique individuality in the face of a world growing increasingly impersonal under the pressure of technology and consumption. I'm glad that a wide range of urgent issues were debated and discussed at the festival. Issues ranging from lyrics to epics, language to religion, and market to modernity. These debates and discussions must have been a rich source of instruction and delight to everyone present at this important cultural event. I sincerely hope that this festival has stimulated the minds of our youth and shown new horizons to them and equipped them with effective tools of analysis. I thank the organizers of the festival for infusing vitality into our cultural life and rendering it ever more vibrant. I'm sure the guests who have been invited from outside have felt very much at home in our state and enjoyed their stay here. Odisha is famous for its hospitality, and the warm generosity of its people is legendary. It embodies a great cultural synthesis imbued with the spirit of humanism. This synthesis has been nurtured for centuries by a rich multi-layered literary tradition. In modern times, writers in Odisha shaped a new idiom to express a sensibility born of attempts to engage with a rapidly changing reality. Some of their works have reached the world outside through translation and received much acclaim. I'm confident that our guests have found an opportunity to discern the emerging trends in Odia literature and Odia writers. For their part, must have benefited immensely from interactions with writers from other linguistic communities. I am sure this exchange will enrich Indian literature and give it new directions. Thank you.
Thank you, Chief Minister, for words of encouragement, short in speech. And if with your permission, because people are here, they would like to know certain views, may I ask a couple of questions, if with your permission?
Of course.
One of the questions which everybody is asking now, suddenly it's a political question, because I'll ask your administrative questions also. One of very important member of your party has suddenly raised a question about a possible alliance with Congress Party. Does it, because people think that nobody in your party can speak without knowing your mind. I don't know without, with your permission, but that will be wrong because I don't know whether he asked you. Is it correct that you are feeling little, the party is feeling little weaker because BJP is emerging stronger and you want to have anti-BJP alliance like many others would like to have?
In fact, the gentleman you're referring to said he's been misquoted, and I've clarified that there's no question of an alliance with the Congress Party. In fact, our policy is to remain equidistant from the BJP and the Congress. You've referred to other parties getting stronger, but just a little more than 2 years ago in the last elections, in a house, in an assembly of 147 seats, the Biju Janata Dal got 116 seats, and the Congress, I think, 16, and the BJP, 10. And we have 21 Lok Sabha members of parliament from Odisha, and the Biju Janata Dal got 20 seats, and the BJP, 1. And there's no signs of those parties growing in strength in the state.
I think that's an appropriate reply, but once this equidistance phrase is very, sometime, very vague. When we say equidistance, which party has a much more distance between you and that party? Congress or BJP? You think less distance between BJP and BJD, or less distance between Congress and BJP and BJD?
Well, let's explain what I've said earlier, that we're equidistant. Equally distant from both parties.
because you have a record of having a past alignment allied with the BJP. So therefore that question comes in the mind that since somebody from your party first time after 16 years spoke about some kind of alliance, therefore once for all, I think you are still following the same policy of equidistance between Congress and BJP because you have created a record. 110 seats for ward and 20 seats, which has never happened in the past, one party winning except Congress when after independence. But I want to know one thing about why Odisha is still not in the national mainstream name. Because when we talk about Odisha, still people talk about poverty, people talk about what things of the past, and they don't talk about the good things about Odisha.
Well, as you'd referred to, surplus in rice, that is a major achievement. We were a state that was buying rice before 2000, and when our government came to office in 2006, we became a rice exporting state, and as you've mentioned, we're amongst the first three states in the country who are doing very well in agriculture.
No, the question is what, you see, when you read the national newspapers and look at the TV every day, it is more about Dana Manji getting the front pages every day because that kind of incident may be happening in other states as well. But because of Dana Manji or other thing, Dabarkbara and whatever the questions are happening, Odisha is still not able to, being a person like you whose modern mind, who looks ahead, why this image of Odisha has not changed when you have been there for 17 years?
It has changed. For some years now, we've had a policy of 1 rupee rice, that's 25 kgs of 1 rupee rice, that now starvation is very much a story of the past. Also in the last 2 years, we've built 1 million pakka houses. In the next 2 years, we'll certainly see that there'll be no kacha houses in the state. And in many development fields and welfare schemes, Odisha is doing extremely well.
This is another question to have, because you had investment meet, one in Bombay and second, I think, in Bangalore. And third, you are going to have in Odisha, I think. During the last 17 years, the kind of investment which you would have expected and the record which I have seen, it is not much to talk about. Why is it? Is it bureaucracy here which rules according to the people? Or there is something else which is not bringing investment into your state?
No, you see, till 2 years ago, we were amongst the first two states in the country as far as investment goes. There have been certain failures like POSCO, but that is, which is the biggest direct investment in the country, foreign direct investment in the country. But this is because the central government has changed its policy and cannot give them mines. But otherwise, a number of other projects have come up and are doing very well.
Because most of the projects which you invited, for them, POSCO and everything else came, because they have not, international people are not showing that kind of interest which they showed earlier. Do you think it's a negative publicity, or it is bureaucracy, it is something else, which is not, Odisha, such a beautiful state with such a beautiful coastline, is not becoming even the tourist center of India?
That is because it's a global problem. And that global aspect, as far as industry, has to be kept in mind.
Other thing, I think, because now as the elections are coming near, suddenly I saw Mahanadi water dispute, you have raised the issue. After many, I never heard earlier Naveen Patnaik raising that issue. Is it something to do with the panchayat elections, or is it suddenly you realize that you need water over?
No, the problem is that if the Chhattisgarh government was going to be building small barrages, that wouldn't be such a problem. But they have plans of building huge barrages, and they have a master plan in which water for most of the year will stop coming from the Mahanadi to Odisha. So naturally, we're very concerned, and we're looking at all aspects, including the legal ones, of how to tackle this problem. We may probably have to go to the courts.
You mean to say Mahanadi issue is nothing to do with panchayat elections?
It's got nothing to do with panchayat elections. It's our concern for water, for irrigation, for power, drinking water. For the state, it's the lifeline of the state.
Another thing which everybody is talking about, Mr. Modi talks about most often, and you are the senior most chief minister in the country now, this cooperative federalism, that he believes in cooperative federalism. And I have not seen much that Naveen Patnaik meeting Modi quite often. He has been there for 2.5 years. You may have met him 2.5 times, or even less than that. Do you think you get a feeling of cooperative federalism, or the way he's running, that no, he's independently running without consulting the states?
Well, I don't think there is much cooperative federalism, because the center has cut off a very large amount of funds which the center used to give to the state for its schemes. So that is definitely a problem for us.
But you mean to say that cooperative federalism, which is just a slogan for Modi, it isn't reality? It isn't,
well, I don't see it being operational, no.
But you still support it on GST?
Yes,
your
GST.
Your party was the number one to support.
On the whole, is a good thing. So why not support that?
So you'll get more money, you think, out of GST?
Well, let's see.
Your GST council, which is going to happen, your finance minister must have said something there.
Well, I certainly hope he will.
Other thing which is happening, because you have been here for 16, 17 years, don't you think the time has come, your party leader somehow feel, that you should be playing also some kind of a national role like your father did? Biju Patnaik's son cannot be but a national leader.
Well, my foremost concern is for the state, and that is what I'm concentrating on.
You don't want to move to Delhi?
No, I don't want to move to Delhi. I've been in Delhi as a central minister, and I'm very content being here, working for the people in Odisha.
So you have some unfinished work to be done here?
A great deal of unfinished work.
because that is because you they think that if you go to national you can people think that you have for the last 17 years you must also be grooming some leaders for the future.
I think the people in their judgment will choose their own leader at the appropriate time. I don't think one should, it's not necessary to groom a leader.
You are not singling out anybody to groom yours?
No, I haven't.
Let the people decide. Your party will choose.
The people will decide.
People decide. The other question which is everybody is thinking about is your lifestyle. Even one of your opponent parties, he admired you for your lifestyle. I just want to ask one simple question. A tall leader like you, how does he feel comfortable in a tiny car, SX4?
Well, that's what the government car is, and I'm quite happy with it.
this is simple. The tiny car, SX4 Maruti, you are the only chief minister out of 30 chief ministers, because most of the chief ministers either have big Fortuners or they have other big cars, and I don't think the SX4 Maruti thought of that a tall man has to comfortably sit in there. You think that it is a symbol of your simplicity, or you want to give a statement, some style statement? No.
It's the car that the government provides, and I'm perfectly comfortable in it.
So tell me one thing, if you have to 17 years you have to count, you give me three important things, structural or policy, which you think they are the best you have done for Orissa, and two worst things which you think you have done.
Well, as I told you, you in fact mentioned it yourself, as far as being a food surplus state. Secondly, the women's self-help group movement has been hugely successful for the livelihoods of more than 5 million women who've been involved. Whatever you may think of industry, certainly it's been a colossal improvement in the past. In our tenure, the production of steel has grown by 5 times. And now we have a new skill development scheme on which we hope we'll have an international brand to make people be self-employed.
What about the two bad things you think? Judgment of error of judgment, you can call it.
Well, I think that Odisha still has the problems of poverty which we are trying to tackle. I think that is the biggest problem.
The image of Odisha you have not been able to change as you expected it to change.
Well, I don't think the image has not changed. I think it's changed considerably.
The last question which I'll ask about the Prime Minister. You tell me one thing. Has he done anything good, or two things you can say, these are the two good things Modi has done, and these are the two bad things which he has done?
Well, I can't think of those right away, but I think he should be given more time. India is a huge country. He ought to be given some more time.
So you are happy with him at the moment?
No, I think a lot has to be done, and he ought to be given time.
Then 2.5 years done nothing which should bother you?
Well, as I spoke to you about the problem of federalism and us being short of funds, that is a major concern.
Thank you very much for giving us that answer. Thank you very much. Give a good applause, friend. Thank you for coming here. I think all of you should.
Thank you. May I now request the managing editor, Event Express, Shampa Kamath, to kindly join us here and propose word of thanks.
Thank you, Mr. Patnaik, for taking time off your schedule. Mr. Chawla. Before we finish, I'd just like to thank all the people who made it possible for us to have this, which I hope was a wonderful edition of the Orissa Literary Festival. Thank you, speakers, for being with us.